Shalom, shalom. This is Amawan from the Lion's Den Camp of Yasha Allah coming at you guys with a brief topic. Hope it's edifying to the Akim, all right, to the Aquafim, to anyone that's out there listening. Before I get into it, I want to give our praises to the Father and the Son in the holy proper names. And I want to say, Kal, Halayim La, Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim, Ha, Rakak, Kodash, Ma'amav. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of GMS. Your salutations to the Akim, all right, to the hopeful elect that's pushing his truth diligently around the four corners of the earth. All right, and I also want to do a double honors to my elders as well at the Lion's Den Camp of Yasha Allah. All right, so the topic I'm getting into today is basically upon the walking away from the world, man, and not walking away from the Lord, you know, Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shah. All right. Because 2/3 of our people, which make up the 12 tribes of Israel, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, all right, they are entrapped in these lusts of the world, all right? They're following after the rudiments of Esau, man, after these heathen, man, you know, being clinging onto this world, man. And the scriptures just tells you to be holy. You know, because Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai made us a holy nation, man. You know, therefore, he wanted us to be separated from everyone else. All right. He wanted us to be grafted into him. All right. Not grafted into this world, man. But our people are love dwelling in folliness, man. All right. But what it says to follow after Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, his ways. All right. After his laws, statutes and commandments. Not the world, all right? Because the world is going to lead you to destruction, man, all right? And that's what it's coming down to, man, you know? Especially with this shift, you know, this great shift that's going on, man, you know? Yahweh Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai is getting ready to shape this place, man, you know, so he can find his gold, you know? But I'm going to go ahead and get into the scriptures. This is 1 John 3, verse 13. It says, marvel not, my brethren, if the world hates you, all right? So don't be surprised, you know, being in this truth, man, calling on the Father's true name and the Son's true name, Yahweh Shai, you know, don't be afraid, you know, or don't be, you know, clueless of what's going on, man, you know, because it's going to be a lot of temptations, it's going to be a lot of adversaries, man, it's going to be a lot of people that's going to say you're doing wrong or see saying you're doing this and you're doing that, all right? But don't listen to none of that, because you're on the right path if you're calling on the Father's true name, all right, and the Son's true name and falling after his will, you know, being called, you know, to do this work. All right. So it says what? Marvel not, my brethren, if the world hates you, because what the scripture says, roughly paraphrasing, it says, if the world hated you, if the world hated me, it hated you. Now let me get that scripture. Let me get it. All right, St. John chapter 15, verse 18. It says, if the world hates you, ye know that it hated me before it hated you. If ye were of the world would love his own. But because ye are not of the world, because Khan, Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai called us holy. You know, 1/3 of the nation of Israel and 144,000 of the whole field elect is going to be the one that's not going to be afraid, all right, you know, of this world, all right, of it hating them. All right. It says, if you were of the world, the world would love his own. But because ye are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hate of you. So Khan, for the ones that's being called to do this work, man. All right. The ones that claims to be a part of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai's camp. All right. As well as his army. All right. The world is going to hate you. All right. The world is gonna hate you, man. But hey, but it's a good thing. It's a good cause because you know you're doing something right, man. Hey, man. So just keep on that pathway of righteousness, you know, to Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, all right. And you know everything will be revealed unto you, man. All right. So back at the scriptures, it says, "Marvel not." So don't be, you know. Don't have no crazy thoughts about, you know, anybody not liking you or, you know what I'm saying, not accepting you, man. Hey, we're not looking to be accepted, man. We're looking to be accepted from your Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, man. Because that's all that matters, man. You know? And our people are full of pride, man. They're full of pride. They're full of the deceitfulness of their hearts, man. They're thinking that everything revolves around them, man. Especially our people, man. You know? But, hey, the pride is getting ready to be shut down in due time, man. It's already being shut down, man. Bump that, you know. You got this thing out, man. You know, our people, you know, they want to cleave onto this life, this so-called comfortable life, you know. But, hey, everything is going to be flipped in due time, man. Hey, the Lord, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah, going to shake everybody out their boots, man. All right. The next scripture is going to be the book of Sirach or Ecclesiasticus, chapter 10, verse 12. This is the beginning of pride is when one departed from Yahweh and his heart is turned away from his maker, man. And that's what our people are. Our people are full of pride, man. They're full of the folliness of this world, man. You know, and by them having that pride, they are turned from Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. They are alienated from him, man, because they want to choose their ways, man. But their ways is deceitful above all things, man. With the heart is deceitful above all things, man. And that's how our people follow. They follow after their hearts, all right, and not from the mind, man. They're not following Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai through their mind, all right. They caught up in the flesh. They caught up in the lust of the eyes, man. Where they are blinded from seeing Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, you know. And that's where that pride comes from. That pride comes from Esau, all right? You know, Esau's doctrines, man, false philosophies that he's spewing out his mouth, man. It's full of abominations, man, you know? Because what it says right here in 1 John chapter 2, verse 15, it says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world, all right? If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him, man. So if you love the things of this world, man, the love of the Father is not in you, all right? You caring about, you know, gaining in the society. You know, you care about what kind of style you're wearing or what kind of money that you bringing in, man. You know, it's not about that, man. You know, it's about gaining the knowledge of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. You know, seeing who, you know, believing on them, you know, realizing who you are, man. You know, realizing that you are not black, you're not African American, man. You know, you're not Puerto Rican, you're not Mexican, man. We are Israelites, man. You know, and Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah called us to be a part of his building, man. You know, a part of his kingdom, man. But our people don't want that. They want to be a part of Esau's kingdom, man. They're stuck in that Stockholm syndrome, you know. They love chasing after Esau. They love falling after his way. They love eating the false things of what Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah told them not to eat, man. Hey, like pork, shrimp, you know what I'm saying? You know, all these abominable foods, man. They love dwelling in it, man. Just like how they love dwelling in folly, man. You know? But what it says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life is not of the Father, but it's of the world. You know? And it's, you know, a lot of these wacky tacky Christians, man, you know, they love, you know, love saying, God knows my heart, you know, but still want to go out and dwell in folliness and shit, man. You know, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai ain't hearing it, man. You know? Yeah, he know your heart. He know your heart full of wickedness, man. You know? You know, like the scripture says, you know, they said, my people have a zeal for Yahweh, but not according to knowledge, man. You know, they be quick to acknowledge him, but don't want to hear him. Don't want to follow after his law, statutes, and commandments, Shalakia, you know. That's the flesh, man. That's the lust of the eyes, man. You know, and the lust of the flesh that our people can't get enough of, man. Hey, but the hopeful elect can't get enough of you. How about Shimei Yahusha? That's why we keep on seeking him, you know, 10 times more. You know, that's what we want to do. That's what we want to. That's how we want to live, man. We want to live through righteousness and not through wickedness, man. Hey, this wickedness is being turned upside down, man. Hey, this kingdom is being turned upside down, man. Why would you want to be a part of this, man? This is not a righteous kingdom. This is not an everlasting kingdom, man. This shit is getting ready to fall. It is falling, man. Fuck that. You heard about Shimei Yahusha, man. His kingdom is the ultimate kingdom, man. That's the everlasting kingdom that you want to be a part of, you know, where you can rule, not be in captivity, you know, because our people are in captivity in their mind, man, physically and spiritually, man. You know, but the way out of that is through the Father and the Son, man, believing on them. You know, having faith, man. You know, that's why we gotta walk away from this world, man. Cause this world is not for us, man. It's all to tear us down, man. To lead us into the destruction. All right, this is James 4:4. It says, "Ye adulterers and adulteress, know ye not that the friendship of the world is enmity with Yahweh? Whosoever therefore be a friend of this world is an enemy of Yahweh." Come on, man. So if you are part of this world, you are alienated, man. Meaning that you are separated from the Father and the Son, you know. In the instance, if you are a friend of this world, enmity, that means that you are enmity with Yahweh, which means you are against Yahweh, man. All right. So if you for this world, then you're not for Yahweh. All right. And Yahweh is the one who created you, man. Yahweh, which means he exists. You know, our people don't want to exist, man, through Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh. They want to coexist through Esau, the so-called white man, the Caucasian race. They don't want to be a part of royalty. They want to be a part of, you know, folly, man, and the stupid shit that Esau got going on, man. Hey, but hey, man. How about Shimei Yahusha got no missiles, ICBM missiles ready to be shot, all right, for the wickedness, for the people that doesn't want to be a part, all right, of his great army, man, that doesn't want to be a part of the kingdom to come, you know. But what it says right here, Matthew 6:24, I'm going to go down to Romans 12:2, it says, "And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of Yahweh," man. Hey, so remove yourself from this world, man. Walk away from this world, man. Just like how you walk away from your woman, or just how you know what I'm saying, walk away from a job, man. Walk away from this world, man, because it's not worth it, man. Yahweh Baal Shem Yahusha, you know, in these scriptures, it's going to be the stability of our time, man. You know, eating these scriptures, eating the whole roll, all right, consuming all of it, man. You know, because what it says in scripture, roughly paraphrasing, it says, "Man shall not live by bread alone," man. You know, but everything that proceeds out of the mouth of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahusha, man. Hey, this is the bread and this is the meat. This is the water. This is what we should be consuming and eating daily, man. You know, hey, amen. Cause this place is getting ready to be turned upside down in due time. Hey, Jacob's trouble is here. All right. So I'm gonna leave off with the last scripture of Matthew 6:24. It says, "No man can serve two masters." All right. "For either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve Yahweh and mammon." All right, so it's either one or the other, man. You can't dip and dab and be one foot in and one foot out. All right, hopscotching and, you know, back and forth. You can't do that shit with Yahweh Baal Shem Yahusha, man. That will make you a lukewarm person. And then Yahweh Baal Shem Yahusha will spew you out his mouth, man, and say he never knew you, man. So you got to choose a side, and you got to choose it now, man. Amen. Because scripture says, it says, "Seek him early while he is found," man. Hey, because in due time, man, hey, these scriptures, man, the prophecies is not going to be out on the highways and byways. They're not going to be out anywhere to be, you know, for you to hear the words of truth, man. For you to hear the words of righteousness, man. hey man, a feminine of the world is coming, man. And so is when you hear, you know, you're supposed to take heed, you know. Of course you have to pray, you know, to the Father and the Son and make sure you're hearing the right things. That's most important. But you're supposed to hear, man. You know, our people got their ears stopped up. They want to hear what they want to hear, man. And that's what's going to lead them down the wrong path, man. You know, listening to everybody else, man. You know, listen to all these abominable philosophies, man. So what it says, be not conformed to this world, man, but renewing your mind by the transformation of your mind, man. Being reconciled back into the sheepfold of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah, you know, that you may prove what is good, man, and acceptable, to be accepted, you know, from Yahweh Shah, man. Hey, amen. That's all we're looking for. We're looking to be accepted from Yahweh and Yahweh Shah, man. Fuck this world, man. This world is going to leave you with nothing, man. You're going to be empty-handed, and you're going to be in a shameful mindset and when the day of the Lord come, man. Because it says that the Lord is going to come in the thief of the night, man. So if he catch you, if you're caught up in this world, man, you're going to be caught up in these unawares, man. And going to be destroyed, man. So with that being said, I want to say shalom. Call Allah, you lie, you how about Shem Yahweh Shah. Walk away from this world, man. You know, walk to your how about Shem Yahweh Shah, man. They waiting for you, man. Seek him early while he is found, man. Hey. And I'm going to say, call halayim la, yahawa ba hashim yahushah, ba hashim ha rakah, kudash ma'amaf. And again, double honors to the apostles and the elders of GMS and salutation to the occupants pushing his truth and sincerity, man. All right, we almost out of here, man. Shalom.